God bless you today. It's always a joy to have you here. And you know, sometimes you may wonder, especially if you're visiting, why are y'all so loud? Why do you sing so long? Why do y'all shout? You know what? Praise precedes the victory. As you are giving God praise today, you know what? Your praise is just sending out your faith. That's allowing God to just arrange things in your favor. I love that song that we were singing. Well, they're all good, but I like that one that says, I know who I am. Because if you're going to live in victory, you got to know that you are a child of the Most High God. You are supposed to live a victorious life, an abundant life. You're not supposed to live under your circumstances. You're supposed to rise above your circumstances. You're supposed to reign in life, even like the scripture says, as a king. So I just encourage you today that, you know, I was talking about a little earlier how, you know, during the week it's easy to have things that try to pull us down, and maybe somebody offended you, or you went through a disappointment, or you made a mistake and you're kind of mad at yourself. But you got to let every day be a new beginning. You got to just receive God's mercy for today and say, God, I'm not going to live this day dragging the negative things from yesterday. I'm starting afresh and anew. I'm forgiving the people that hurt me. I'm letting go of every disappointment. I'm not going to dwell on who did me wrong or what didn't work out. God, I'm just believing today is the day you have made, and I'm going to live this in faith and expectancy. I'm starting afresh and anew. I really believe you got to do that the first of every day. You just got to get your vision back, get your focus back, get your thoughts going in the right direction. Because the enemy will try to keep you down and discouraged. Oh, yeah, but the hurricane, the economy. He'll give you 1,000 reasons to live your life negative and defeated. But you got to shake that off and say, no, I'm not going there. I know the joy of the Lord is my strength. I know God's got me in the palm of his hand. I know he holds victory in store for the upright. I say this probably every week, but you wouldn't be alive if God didn't have greater victories in front of you. You have not seen your greatest victories yet. You have not seen your best days. They are still out in front of you. But you know what? You got to do your part, and you got to stir it up on the inside. You got to get it on the inside. You got to see it through your eyes of faith before it's going to come to pass on the outside. So I just encourage you today. You know, God can do what men can't do. It may look impossible to you, but it's not impossible with God. Jesus put it so simple. If you believe, all things are possible. I believe I'm looking at believers and not doubters today. You know God can do supernatural things. So today we're going to take a moment or two to pray. But like I said, I always like to stir you up in your faith, because God works where there's an attitude of faith. God is not moved by our tears. He sees our tears, but God is moved by our faith. God is not moved when we go around, oh man, I'm depressed, I'm discouraged. God, you got to help me. No, God sees that, but God is moved when you say, God, I got some problems, but I'm trusting you. I believe that you're in control. I know that you can make a way. I know who I am. I'm a child of the Most High God. When you get your faith out there, that's what moves God. So while we're in this attitude of faith, if you've got something that's bothering you today, trying to pull you down, don't go home that way. We'll have prayer partners at the front of your section during this next song. You need prayer, come on down. You don't have to be a member. Even up there at the top, there'll be prayer partners. You can come down and receive prayer. And the rest of us, we're going to continue to worship the Lord. But we're so glad to have you here today.